Hey everyone, how's it going? Octopus here, welcome back to Union Cross, and we're talking about the new metal, Kingdom Hearts 3 Dark Riku. They keep dropping more and more metals, and they're all about in the same range. Some of them are PvE, some of them are PvP, some can do both, but they're all doing the same thing right now. If you guys are in the era where you pulled Axel, Elsa, what is the power one? Cloud. If you guys got any of those medals, those two-turn buffers, you're perfectly fine to skip on everything else. I can show you the back-to-back in this video about it, but honestly, straightforward, you don't need to upgrade yet, and your jewels are worth more than anything else. But we're going to be talking about this, events that are ending, and new events coming out as well, too, because JP got the update, and we usually get the same thing globally. So let's jump in, and let's talk about everything that's going on right now, starting off with the banner of Kingdom Hearts 3 Dark Riku. So banner-wise, banner is really good. 5 Mercy Pull, VIP coins every pull, trait metal every pull, and 3 gems every pull for speed gems. So banners, I like them. Again, if you have the power already, your jewels are worth more because they keep coming out with 5 mercy pulls, and these medals are always amazing and better than the other one or just about the same. So you don't have to pull for everything. If you're going for waifu and husbandos, then yeah, go for it. If you're perfectly fine where you are, you can skip these banners. If this medal is worth it and the banner's worth it, it is a really good banner and it's a really good medal. So again, it's only if you need the upgrade. Now, what does the medal do? It's a PvE slash PvE medal. So it's an all-arounder. It's really strong. So that has a critical 50% thing. And the best way to explain that is like every other metal in the game, it has a condition for having a high multiplier or a small multiplier. In this case, it's a high multiplier into a very high multiplier. So he got damage from 84.92 to 106.15. That is really a big multiplier, but you have a 50% chance of that happening. So critical rate 50% is just to get that bigger multiplier. If not, we get the smaller one. And we've had medals like this before. I don't really like them that much, but it doesn't mean that they're bad. This is still really, really strong metal, even if you don't hit that 50%. If you do, a lot stronger. But these are usually metals that show the future multipliers of metals coming out very soon. This is just like the first ones that come out and be like, all right, it has this little bit of a condition. But when I say soon, I mean like months. So don't be like, oh, it's gonna be replaced. It's gonna be replaced like long time, you know what I mean? Especially the rest of the stuff that this guy does, it's really strong. So for 6 hits, 2 turns, he buffs your speed metal strength for 2 turns by plus 3,000. So with extra attack, that's 6,000. He increases all your buffs and debuffs for reverse speed and general by 15. So you don't really need a buffer on your keyblade. You can just use him, especially doesn't require higher HP. So it doesn't matter. So if you're someone who likes to fill the keyblade with just one metal, he is possible to do that. But, you know, we have Renova metals now. We don't want to do that. We want those Renova casts into these. It's very powerful. But that's just an idea there. Then he's got increasing your guilt by 200%, which is not needed because of supernovas. He ignores enemies' counters, so deal 6 hits doesn't mean anything. He just ignores those counters, so blue counters, red counters, he will not affect them. And here's the PvP part. He pierces defense by 30%, so very strong PvP metal. And again, that critical hit chance, if that critical hit goes through and that 30% goes through, big numbers, man. He's going to be really, really good. Now, for his supernova, he is a supernova plus, so you have to put plus 5,000 chips and dales to increase his strength, and that's why he hits 45,000, so you have to have a lot of chip and dales still laying around. Now, his multiplier is 240 for the supernova. It is a two-turn buff that increases your speed metal strength by 6,000, which is really strong, and he's got more buffs in his supernova, which is always nice to see in attacking metal. He gives strength, reverse, and speed strength by 15, and defense, reverse, and speed defense down by 15. So perfect buffs and debuffs, again, in his supernova, and not only just his cast, which is really nice to see. He increases your guilt by 300% and ignores targets' defense boost. So again, he pierces defense by 30% for his normal attacks. He deals 6 hits, so that's a lot of chances of that piercing through. And then his supernova just ignores all the defense boost, so it doesn't matter in PvP. So very strong PvP metal, very strong PvE metal. There is going to be better PvE metals, and there is already a strong amount out there. It's basically, if you think about it, he's like the sorcerer. He has the same kind of multiplier. If you look at his sorcerer, 88.79, weaker multiplier, if that 50% doesn't go through, 84.92. And that's why that 50% doesn't really matter, because like his small multiplier is still up there with some of the good reverse metals. And we don't have a lot of good reverse metals, so he is on top of the charts for reversed. Become reverse magic and reverse speed is usually our weakest points. Reverse power gets so much love. Reverse magic and reverse speed is always so awkward. And it's not that there's not enough of them, it's just that we always pull for the other ones. And when it finally comes around to the one or two that we get of these, we're out of jewels. So it's really hard to say. If you guys want to work on your reverse setups, yeah, these guys were probably the best pickups at the moment. But you can see they have the same thing. 2 turns, metal strength, magic metal strength by plus 3,000. Supernova has 6,000. You know what I mean? It's got all the buffs and debuffs for itself for magic and reversed. and it reflects 100%. So these reverse metals are becoming the PvP metals, but also useful in PvE. But again, if you're running Axels, if you're running the new Cloud, if you're running Elsa, you're perfectly fine. You know what I mean? And there is a couple metals that just came out. There are two-turners, buffers, and we're going to get more two-turn buffers. But what you guys should be looking at are those Renova metals to really pick up that supernova that's getting bigger. So that's the biggest key here. You still need those Renova metals because this is getting stronger and stronger and stronger. So is the buffs for two turns. But Supernova with Renova, if you cast Renova twice, so if you have like Ventus two times on your first slot and your friend slot, you can get 18,000 for two turns just off casting Supernova. And then you've got 6,000 on the second turn just from one metal over here. Very powerful. The two turn buffers with the Renova, very, very powerful. So leave some room there if you guys want to go for future Renova medals, or Terra, Ventus, and Aqua have still not been replaced, and the TVA medal, they still are the supreme Renova medals, the only ones in the game. So that's a little heads up. Kind of look towards that. Again, if you have if you have Axel, Elsa, Cloud, or Sephiroth, then your speed, power, and magic setups are set. You should be saving and getting ready for that Renova push, or metals that are stronger than this. Because as long as you have Renova and two-turn buffers, doesn't matter if it's the newer ones or the older ones, you should be fine for all the content. So if you're new in the game, you should be picking up these guys for the two-turn buffers if your speed setups are not looking too good. Even if your speed setup is the missing ache instead of the sleeping lion, you're just a reverse setup. It's no big deal. It's always good to have a reverse setup, because when they throw reverse quest on us saying only reverse metals, you're set. You know what I mean? So besides that, the metal itself, yeah, it's a good pickup. It's a good pickup if you don't have any of the metals I talked about before. Even if you have Tifa, Tifa is fine as well too. Even though Tifa's not that whole two-turn buffer, she's still fine to have and not get this. So as long as you have Tifa, you don't have to get this either. So besides Dark Riku, let me know what you're doing with Dark Riku, if you're pulling him, if you're skipping. Me personally, I'm skipping again because I'm down to 15,000 jewels. But we're going to be jumping into the new events going on, and there's a lot. They're coming back. We're getting the draw tickets again. Draw tickets are so good. We now have a points banner and we have draw tickets. The game is looking way better again for free-to-play players and just players in general. Just, they're throwing love. A lot of love back out there, and I like to see that. So we do have all these events coming on, and this is the whole schedule over here. To break this down really quickly, I'm going to go over Robloid's post. Robloid and Eileen, thank you guys so much for translating everything. You guys are amazing. It's always just 1 or 2 days ahead of time, but hey, it's always good to know 1 or 2 days ahead of time. So for the events going on right now, we've got a surprise event that will be held starting on the 5th, and it says question mark. Ooh. We got reprinted avatar boards, PSM boosts on Keyblades, boost from the reverse event, Chasm of Challenges coming back, deluxe PvP rewards. You got to take on the delightful upright defender and get 30 times the gems. Proud modes, you've got your everything pretty much here going on. Big bonus challenge, 5,000 jewels. We got Goofy's birthday event. There's a lot of cool things coming up. So this whole month has a lot going on. And the biggest things is obviously the big bonus challenge. The deluxe raid, reward raid week is on 5/11. Right here, it's a Monday. Up to 3,000 jewels and 90 stones. Really, really good right there. So there's a lot of stuff to look forward to. So, and there's a lot of stuff going on right now too. But those are the biggest ones. I see 3,000 jewels. I see 5,000 jewels. A bunch of gems because I want to make all my Keyblades level 50. And then, of course, Heroes Power Challenge events. You know, 10-turn challenge event. There's a lot of different events that we haven't seen for a while coming up. And I'm looking really forward to them. So, Critical Event versus Ifrit. You know what I mean? That's on the 25th. Yeah, 25th is, let's see, Raid Drop Event. Magical Drop Event, Raid Drop, Goofy's Birthday, and Critical Event versus Ifrit. So, I'm looking forward to a lot of these stuff. A lot of stuff's happening. There's new avatar boards, old avatar boards coming back as well, too. If you guys didn't get the Heiner, Pence, and Olette, you guys have all that going on as well, too. Plus, a lot of those old boards. So, jewels, you still need them. Be careful not to pull a whole bunch. If you care about all the little cosmetics going on, all the little avatars you can put on, there's a lot of cool things going. But for events that are ending, let's talk about those. All right, so back to the game. If you guys haven't done this, ends in 5 hours. Hey, I haven't done Coliseum. Coliseum currently The rewards are definitely worth it, and clear most of it for the Coliseum boards. So if you guys haven't done this, you're missing out on Attack Boost 12 Max SP Gauge 0. So tonight, if I have enough time, I'll try to push as much as I can. I'm probably going to put on Auto Battle on the side and just let it go through as far as it can just to get something. So don't forget that, like I did on both my accounts. We do have Raid Hour finishing in 5 hours as well, along with the Organization 13 event, Anniversary, there's jewels in there, 1,000 for the quiz, Mickey, if you guys haven't farmed the trait medals like me, there's Mickey event there, Hades Cup, 6,000 jewels, don't forget it. If you guys didn't face Sephiroth, a lot of stuff ending tonight, Organization event, I didn't do most of it, and also the monthly gem quest. So hopefully this video gets to you in time. I know it didn't get to me in time, but I got things to do. I have 2 kids, Penelope and Zelda, and I barely got time to play all the gacha games I play these days. So some things get missed, some things don't. It's not going to hurt. Again, if you're a newer player and you've missed like 3 years worth of content, are you upset about all those jewels, all those gems, all those avatars you've missed? No, right? If you miss a couple events here and there, it's no biggie. I know it kills you inside when it does happen, but it's no biggie. You don't have to get everything. It definitely helps. But you don't have to get everything. That's pretty much it, guys. If I missed anything or you want to add anything, leave it down below in the comment section. I want to know if you guys are going for the Dark Riku. Me, personally, I'm skipping. And you guys know my reasons. I value jewels a lot. And as long as I can pass the content, I ain't touching them. If you guys did enjoy the video, don't forget to hit the like button. And as always, thank you so much for watching. Keep on smiling. And I'll smell you later.